after we played those games, almost beating every team by 40 points, it made us think like, yeah, you know, go undefeated. We can achieve these goals that we set for our team.
It's a challenge to get these guys to really buy into the fact that they really haven't played their best.
Our ability to respond to adversity is hands down second to none.
It's kind of a morale booster, really. All your hard work led up to this.
High school boys basketball champion are the father of the
with a 4 points.
Fortunately, as brothers, we came together and we pulled through.
I know Thompson's watching us. Let's go.
Take the player, you make him a man.
Day one, I told them, we're going to outwork people and we're going to outsmart people. And if we do that, we'll find ourselves in position to win. One of the things we talk about in our basketball program is value. No matter who you are, no matter how many minutes you play, you bring value.
I think we have a sense of urgency. And I think a lot of that has been prepped by losing last year. So I think our seniors are on a mission. I think as a coaching staff, we've had to really self-reflect and say, what can we do differently? How can we be better this year? It does help to have the players that we have this year. But at the same time, it's about sort of getting better season by season.
Early on, okay, I think it's trying to create and establish the culture that we want to establish. What is our identity? What do you want to bring to this table?
Kyle Camacho, class of 2020. Matthew Ferger.
Chris LG.
Isaiah Pokey. I play guard for the Father Drainage Friars.
Colin Santiago, point guard.
Raymond Castro and class of 2020.
We're gonna get out of this on the winning side.
When every season ends, you kind of look and you kind of see what type of players you have coming back, what your returnees look like, and you kind of get an initial feel of what that team may look like. Obviously, when tryouts start, there's always going to be a few people that kind of throw a wrinkle into that. Nathan coming in was a surprise for us.
Blaze Adam, freshman.
Coming into tryouts, I knew we were going to have a pretty talented team because I know me and my seniors, we were going to bring it this year. And, you know, juniors stay solid.
I think our size combined with our team speed and our unselfish attitude right now are some of our biggest attributes.
We know we're successful if we've got seniors talking to juniors, juniors talking to sophomores, sophomores talking to freshmen.
Goals for the season coming into tryouts, it was to, you know, of course, go undefeated the whole season, to win all the championships that they had set up.
Ball's at Colin, where we at? Colin, drive to the basket. Remember, it is the low split that steps up to take this charge. Do we understand that? Lowe will step up, Elijah will drop, and he will gap the weak side. He will play.
Once we got in the actual tryouts, we started to see, okay, what kind of pieces kind of fit good here. We knew we had Matt. We knew we had Isaiah and Colin. We obviously had to find a way to make Isaiah and Colin coexist. So I kind of tasked Coach Fernandez with the responsibility of, I need a transition offense and a couple sets that allow us to play with 2 point guards and allow us to play with a more traditional 2-post set versus a smaller post. So he went, he did his research for about, you know, 5 or 6 months, brought me a couple things, and in tryouts, we slowly started putting pieces of it together just to see how it would fit. We felt confident enough to roll with it, and then kind of decided, okay, we got to build the team around this concept now. We've got the true post players, we have the point guards that we need, so now we can run this transition, we can play at this pace.
In the preseason, as we're putting in our defensive and offensive playbook, it's just guys getting understanding their roles and really buying into their roles short term. I believe that from a habit perspective, it's guys coming in, starting games consistently, being consistent in our effort, being consistent in how we approach games, no matter who our opponents are.
To try to keep everybody mentally working and playing hard at a high level is very difficult, okay? There's the human factor there that's involved, okay, in everybody. And you're dealing with 15 to 17-year-old young men here, okay? How do you motivate them to come in each and every day to practice, to work that hard? That's really a big task.
Matthew, try and make him go up the sideline. Once he gets close to that sideline, we want to come, and we're going to cut down the lane, off the sideline. Chris is going to come immediately, and he's going to take everything to the middle and up the line.
The past 3 years, you wouldn't think like, oh wow, we're going to come out and be like this kind of team, you know?
Starting today, we run wild on everybody that steps on the court, our court. Day one of many. Play hard, play smart, play together, play the win. We're brothers, boys, let's do this.
I want to test their depth today. I want to see how deep they're willing to go with us today. Coming back on the backside so we don't put pressure on our bigs. That'll minimize the quality shot attempts that they have.
Are we going to come out today and play with relentless effort?
You know, some of the expectations coming into the game is we wanted to play fast. We wanted to play the way we've been playing for the past 2 weeks in practice. We wanted to make a statement on defense, you know, proving to the teams out there that we're a defensive team and we're going to stop you.
There is no such thing as junk minutes on this team. When you get a chance to play on the court, your teammates expect your best.
Game goes, but the ultimate result is it's how we play. Can we correct ourselves? Can we make those self-improvements? That's what this tournament is all about.
I told you in the beginning, they're not gonna quit. They're not gonna be scared. They're not gonna give up. Yes, this is a great step in the right direction. We worked harder than everybody. We worked smarter than everybody. And we're coming out of this tournament a better team.
The champions of the game featuring the SP Fighters and the JFK Islanders.
Free throw line. They're 8 of 10. Way too many. 10 fouls, guys. 10 fouls in the first half. That is a lack of discipline. They're playing with more heart than we're playing with right now. They're showing that they want the game more than we want the game. And you know why? You know why? Because we are starting to play as individuals again while they're getting each other's back and playing as a team. But hey, we're not even playing that well. We're not executing anything on offense, and I don't even know if we're still winning or not, but it's a tight game.
We just stuck together. That's like the whole thing about this team, just staying together no matter what. And yeah, we had a slow start, but watch the film. That third quarter is crazy.
but we accomplished our three goals. Winning that championship just icing on the cake. But remember, we still got a long way to go.
And congratulations to the 2020 GSPN preseason basketball tournament champions, the FD Friars.
Listen, so we're defensive sliding, drop step, change direction, all right? So that's all we're doing, zigzag all the way to half court.
Still early in the season, so you know our offense was kind of iffy, and you know our defense was still there, but you know we just had a hard time scoring.
Learning a brand new offensive system is tough, and you can see their frustration. And when you see a player frustrated, it shows that they care. I know we can defend because we've never had a 6'9" shot blocker on the backside. So I know we'll be able to play up and down and defend a full game, 32 minutes of high school basketball in your face. So once we can score points, you know, the sky was the limit.
Trying to get the right lineups, okay? Trying to mesh the right people. Who's in your first team? Has this person been able to deliver?
Not listening to what others say about us. I think that's the biggest obstacle, is when you have a little bit of success, it's easy to pat yourself on the back and look at yourself and say, hey, we're pretty good.
When you go through our program and you understand humility and things like that, and you taste success and understand that it's shared, it's what we breed here. Is, you know, you do anything you can to achieve that.
I would describe it as a tight-knit community here at FD. We always got each other's backs no matter what. That's just how it's always going to be.
The spirit that we have here, you know, touches these students, and once you graduate from here, you know, you have a special bond. We look forward to these new students that come in here, and they hear about our brotherhood. They hear about how special these people are.
You're there with the boys, so you're true to yourself. You're true to how you want to learn in school. You're true to how you are to other people.
It's a pride, like a good pride, not a bad pride. You know, and you look out for each other. And whenever you get to see these guys, Dwayne and Smith outside, no matter how many years it's been, you still get that. You'll feel the connection, and that's brotherhood.
About our pace and the pace that we want to play with, we can't get out and play fast if we aren't rebounding.
It's really important that we get a great start. Okay, a great start will really show how prepared we are and what we've done.
Right. Talking just for the sake of talking is not efficient if it's not effective. If we're not saying the things we're supposed to say when we're supposed to say them, when we jump, verbalizing so our backside can go and make that rotation. Focus on the little things. And let's give them the show. Let's go.
Turnovers, and they're playing a zone. I want you to think about that. Let that marinate for a little bit. We have 14 turnovers, and they are playing a zone. I'm going to keep my cool. We have 4 assists. We have 8 personal fouls. We are 1 of 6 from the three-point line, and we are 2 of 10 from the free throw line. I don't know what's going to make you understand that in order for us to be at our best, it requires a buy-in from everybody on this team. And that buy-in is, when I'm playing defense, I'm gonna do my individual job. Non-existent. They believe they can win. Listen to that. You know what I mean? I don't believe it. But like I said since day one, what I believe doesn't matter if you don't believe it. They're driving baseline and we got no one rotating. We have no one gapping there. That's what our weakness is right now.
Let's go. Let's go, boys.
The disparity with our play is still real large right now. I mean, we narrowed it and then tonight I think we just really took a couple steps back out of it.
The show is Friars basketball. The show isn't Matt, the show isn't Elijah, the show isn't Isaiah. The show is playing Friars basketball, and that's what we're trying to get you to buy in.
Let's go. Together on 3, 1, 2, 3.
Together.
Disappointing of a regular season opener. I think we kind of still were on the high of winning that GSPN preseason tournament, and we kind of didn't get ourselves out of the clouds yet. So we went in there and we were in for a rude awakening.
Well, we had a lot of confidence in ourselves. I mean, it just showcased what we could do, you know, when we play as a team. And but we also have to stay consistent because, you know, yeah, we can win all these games in the beginning, but everybody's just starting their season, so anything can happen. Like, teams get better, or you know, we face tough teams at their homes, so we have to face adversity.
When you think about it from a big picture standpoint, obviously you've got to win, but you've got to come out with that mindset that we've got to play our brand of basketball. We know that we've had all our success defensively.
The level of competition in this region is second to none. You're playing against a lot of American kids, a lot of kids that are DOD dependents that have been exposed to bigger, better, stronger competition in the States. So many times we fall into this realm or we fall into this hole of we're just going to be the best on our island. Why do you put yourself in a box like that? Why don't you go and say, I just want to be the best, period? So I think it's important at a young age for these kids to get exposed to that, to see a higher level of competition, to see a higher level of coaching, a higher level of officiating, and to kind of have them really see the big picture of what basketball can do for them.
Confident going into the tournament, you know, we have the next man up mentality. Our team's deep this year. We can go all the way in. So just every person is going to get reps, and we got a number of games. We got a long stretch ahead of us, so everybody's going to get minutes. Everybody's going to get touches.
Thank you.
blooded, bro. Just straight up sweater.
Hey, and Guayu, that just wearing a long sleeve.
I don't know why you guys let the young boys stand at the back and you don't get up to work a little bit.
The biggest difference we're gonna face out here is size and speed. You know, seeing 6'2 guys have the same speed as 5'6 guys on Island, I mean, that's going to be a huge difference. So I think we're ready for it. I mean, we've kind of taught the game to be prepared for it at our school. So we're just looking forward to a great challenge, man.
I kind of know what to expect here in Japan because I played with these guys in the summer and I also played against them last year. So I'm excited to go up against the competition here.
We have nothing to lose. No one expects anything out of us. You understand? But we do. So let's just hold ourselves accountable.
Out a rebound, we didn't communicate defensively. We were out of position almost the entire game offensively. We sucked. We stunk up the gym.
We have to be technically sound. Okay? Offensively, push the pace.
Great start. And that was my biggest concern, okay, about and talking to Coach Eddie. Okay, we need to get great starts.
We saw today how easy the game can be when we can play good defense, turn them over, and generate easy transition baskets. Back. Of the things that we have control over, because that's the difference. Do you understand? So you want to point a finger, look right at it, and point it right at you, and do your job. That's it. That's all we're asking of everybody right now.
we are. Another tough gym to play in. Had to travel a little bit to get here. We're in the single elimination part of the bracket now. It's been a tough 2 days. You know, we started off real flat, kind of fixed it in two games, and got a little bit of fatigue and tiredness, some of this cold weather getting to us, and here we are 2-2 heading into the single elimination bracket. We got a tough Yokota team to face now, but it's king of the hill. We got a big hill to climb. Got to win 3, maybe 4 games to win it all. And we're also trying to balance out some of the injuries that we have right now. We got a few guys that are nursing some minor injuries that we need to weigh whether or not it's worth it to play them at this point. So definitely a big hill to climb at this point, but you know, I'm very confident in our ability to stay out and compete.
Uneasy not knowing how we ended the game yesterday, but I knew today one of the things that we have with this team is called resiliency.
Remember, we came here to compete, we came here to win, but we can't get there if we don't take care of this team that just handed us our loss yesterday.
Fires on 3. 1, 2, 3. Fires!
When I came back and we went through our season in 2017, I think it was, and you know, one of the things he told me was, we're coming to that tournament. The FD boys are coming to that tournament. And to be here, to see where we are, to see how far we've come, I really wish he had the opportunity to see this. But I know he's smiling right now.
So with Thompson's passing, I was actually there when it happened. And I remember just like it was yesterday, and then everyone yelling for help, panicking and everything. I couldn't just help but feel overwhelmed. But you know, with everyone that was there, all my brothers from seniors to down to freshmen, we all gathered together, we prayed for him, and we were just hoping for the best outcome.
The island is still in shock after the passing of Mr. Tony Thompson.
He was gonna talk to me that night when I tore my hip. I felt like I always, you know, owed it up to him to you know, play basketball for him.
He left a major void in the FD community, and I don't think anyone realized until of his passing, and that speaks volumes to his impact and what he did for the community.
For Mr. Thompson, he followed the tradition, and he created many traditions here on his own.
that impacted many of these students' lives.
It's a sport we use to teach life lessons. You know, that's what he always said. You know what I mean? You take the player, you make him a man. And you try to take the teachings of this game and you pass that down to these kids. You find a way to make it applicable for them to apply in real life situations and hope that when that time comes and they have to make those hard decisions, that they can lean on some of these experiences to help them with that thought process. And every day I tell myself that's what we gotta do.
I'm with Coach Eddie, okay? I know Thompson's watching us. Let's go.
Hey, all the way up to nine, boys. Ready? One, two, three.
Fires!
So this is gonna be a mano a mano, best of the best right now.
Games in 4 days, most games going against three guys in zebra stripes, and somehow, some way, we stuck together, we grinded it out, and we're the king of this region, man.
Stretch. Our coach has taught us to always believe in each other and next man up, no matter who we have. So he believes that with whatever five guys he got, those five guys can produce for us.
The goals have changed a little bit. You know, we wanted to work harder, we wanted to work smarter, we wanted to improve. Now our goal is we don't want to lose anymore. Never have we ever had a senior group that has been here all 4 years. That's special.
Tonight, we honor seven seniors and their families that have given their heart and their soul to the FD basketball program. Please join the seniors.
For our families and friends, it was something really special. And I'm gonna remember that for my whole life. And to be able to do it with my brothers on this team, it's really great.
At FD, the camaraderie is something that can't be explained when you still see your high school brothers years and years after that. And I think that's what keeps us tight knit.
Come on, come on.
always expect St. Paul to compete at a high level and never give up. When we think about the past and how many games we've been sort of battling in, how many times we've kind of been on the wrong side of those battles. From FD standpoint, of course that's a rivalry. We've lost a lot to them. Bello and Audrey, obviously we can expect excellent guard play. And I think the biggest piece to matching up with them is trying to stay in front and trying to make them make as many mistakes as possible and understand that they're going to have good games against us.
You have two coaches that know each other well. You have two teams that know each other well. So, you know, who's able to execute, take care of all the small details, that's really going to be the difference in the game tomorrow. We got to do a better job executing in the half court. I think the last time we played them, actually the last two times we played them, we've struggled offensively trying to execute. So if we're able to execute a little bit better in the half court and continue to maintain our defensive consistency, I think we'll find a lot of success. Cool.
Communicate, understand pick and roll coverages. Do we understand? Understand our pick and roll coverages and who's the personnel that we're playing against on that.
To one day be on this floor, and you know, especially with these guys, I've been their teammates ever since, and it's nice to see it come full circle, and now I'm the one right here with the trophy, so finally.
Yeah. Went through a lot of adversity this season with like injuries and like referees and all that, but I just made it all the more sweeter. This is the best game I've ever played. It's my favorite so far. We're not done yet, but this one feels really good.
Extremely proud of the selflessness that you've taken throughout the season. I'm extremely proud of the sacrifices that you've made. I'm extremely proud of how much of yourself you've given to your team and how much of yourself you've given up for this team. And we wouldn't be in this situation without everybody, 1 through 16, making that commitment. And, you know, I wanted to just really ensure that last day that I'm extremely proud of what you've done.